Up until a month ago, veterinarians and dairy producers in Texas were dealing with a mysterious disease in dairy cows. Now, the mysterious illness has been diagnosed as the first known infection of bird flu in cattle. I spoke to a dairy specialist in Iowa about the latest on the pathogen as it continues to make its way across the states.
Dairy herds infected with the highly pathogenic bird flu have been confirmed in 8 states, including those close to Iowa and Missouri, in South Dakota and Kansas. Professor Philip Jardin of Iowa State University's Veterinary Extension says although the disease is highly pathogenic for poultry, it does not seem to be highly pathogenic in dairy cows so far.
It's certainly makes them sick for a few days, and they go down in production, but it doesn't kill them, and they seem to recover fairly well from it.
Jardin says that Iowa State University pathologist Drew Magstadt suggested testing the milk for bird flu, which turned out to show the disease being shed in high amounts through the milk. Although there is evidence of cow-to-cow transmission, it still doesn't explain all the ways the disease is spread.
I think we should be worried, but not panicked. And then I think there's also some evidence that this might be spreading from cows to some of the birds, whether it's because of the mutation or whether it's because of just proximity. So I think we need to be careful of that too, and try our best to keep it from coming into Iowa.
The USDA and the Iowa Department of Agriculture recommend minimizing the movement of cattle with evidence the virus has spread between herds. They also suggest minimizing access of wildlife, especially migratory wildfowl and other birds, to cattle and feed. The USDA says they do not believe that the disease will impact the price of dairy or its availability. Iowa Secretary of Agriculture Mike Naig says, quote, "Consumers can feel confident that pasteurized milk and dairy products and properly prepared poultry continue to be safe to enjoy."
Dairy farmers, poultry producers, and veterinarians seeing unusual or suspicious illnesses are asked to report these instances to the Iowa Department of Agriculture.